world, my friend. My name is XaneKudo, and this is a post-commentary for Shantae Part 6. It's because last time in the video, I messed up the audio. I forgot to put the implication that it was for Shantae. But, yeah, this is post-commentary, and it's going to be about a long-ass time. Whew! Over 40 minutes. Nearly 50. As I can tell from me watching it right now. But, that's what I get. So anyway, I'm just going around here looking, and I realized that in the elephant in the desert tower, I could use my elephant powers to actually find something. And Mermaid Falls, there was a twinkly light for the light shard. I'm not going to say where, what's in either one. I'm just going to continue walking on. But anyway, so I realized I have to go to Desert Tower first. Actually, I went to Mermaid Falls first because they said that, because some guy said that the light shard was in Desert Tower. And I tried to believe him and said, sure, why not? Let's go to Desert Tower afterwards. But I decided to go to Mermaid Falls. Alright, and I'm on Mermaid Falls, going to the save guy. I still have no idea what his name is. Things are going on in my house, but anyway, it doesn't matter. Well, here we go. So I decided to just play through it, and I'm commentating over it. I didn't really decide to skip over some things, but I will skip over things that, you know, I won't waste your time on. It's kind of weird actually seeing me play. Anyway, I figured I'd probably go down here and find something. I can enjoy it as I can. And I realize, oh wait, there's something here I can get. So I use the pincer claws, and there we go, the second sword. Nice, we done me. Alright. It's kind of weird not doing it by my own, but whatever, that's just how I roll, I suppose. Anyway, I realized that I have, I kind of forget at some point that I have the mouse powers. And I realized that these lines, I can actually go through them. I can't go through every line, because some of them are closed off and some don't reach that far. Anyway, some jumps in here I have to use the monkey for, only because the monkey jumps higher. Shantae herself doesn't jump as high. I will say one spoiler here, and this is a big spoiler. I do get the heartbeat in this playthrough, so that pretty much solves all the problems I really have. Basically, flying to high places and stuff. The heartbeat, you can fly everywhere. But anyway, I go through here, and I realize that, you know, this is the part where I got the mermaid, and I go back out, and I choose mouse, and I realize I can't jump that high, because that's where I can go. But I apparently can't jump that high. So it's just a monkey again, and I'm out. So that's good enough for me. And that's the light. That's the sparky light where I'm supposed to go. But I don't have a way there, so I was here trying to find a way here, trying to go over there. I wasn't going to be able to go over there. Anyway, I'm just going through the side because I realized that I can actually use the mouse. Collecting monster eggs and stuff along the way. Those monster eggs really don't give a lot of health, strangely enough. The steaks do. Steaks give a much more health. I'm jumping around like an idiot. Actually, no, I should go back here and turn into the mouse. No, I turned to the mermaid first for it by accident and then turned to the mouse. Okay, and now I'm the mouse and I'm just going through here. There's so much traveling as the mouse. So much traveling as the mouse. But, you know, that's how things have to be. Oh, and these enemies here, I can't attack them because simply I am a mouse. So I get to here and I realize that I can actually stop here. I don't have to move. There's no really no stop button. It may look like I'm about to fall out, but apparently he just automatically stops. And I see the calipers coming through me. Luckily, it only goes in those outer lines. It doesn't really travel through the inwards. So I can find myself safe now. As I make my way carefully through everything. I want to try to get up there, but I realize I can't. I probably need the harpy for that one. And I see another of this little small critter coming in, and I try to, oh crap, I realize I was stuck here for a bit. Luckily, I made quick thinking, and now I'm out, and here's the wizard. Hello, wizard. So I'm talking to him. I'm actually saying the lines here. I forgot what voice I used for those lines. Yeah, it is that voice, yeah. But he's using candy, so now I know how to have to give him some candy. So anyway, I use the elephant here to break things out, and now I'm out. And I wish I could go up there, but I can't. I can't do that. And I think I can break through that. Can't. Oh, I just go back through here. Anyway, those rocks on the left, I thought I could go through them, but I couldn't. So anyway, I go through here, and I realize I'm kind of stuck, and there's nothing coming here that can say, yeah, you can travel on me. So anyway, I get hit, and that's it. So then, I guess I think I try a little more things here. Actually, I should try going through here this time. Yeah, now I remember. I actually go through here. And I stop. Pajama time. And we're going out. And I go through there. I don't know where this leads me to, or leads me to there. Which I already been through before, and I realized that the other area is just a dead end. What a god goose chase. Yeah, this is gonna be quite a while. So if you hear me drinking something, that's probably me just, you know, giving my throat a rest, because trying to talk throughout the entire thing as post commentary is a lot more difficult, especially when you don't have anything to keep your mouth, you know, hydrated and moist. Because then you feel your throat, your tongue drying, like I do right now. But anyway, I'm trying to explore and try to see exactly what I can do here. It's because I know that I can go to the other part, but I just don't know how to. I realize there's a part here. I probably could have went through there, now that I think about it. You know, some things you only find out once you actually do replay everything that you can go through. Anyway, I waste a lot of time on this part. I remember, I waste a lot of time because you'll see in a bit, probably either through this time or the second time I come back here. Because the second time I come back here, I give the guy the candy. Okay. But yeah, you'll see. If this is this part, then yeah, I'll explain it. But if it's in the second part, then you'll know. But I don't think I spend too much time here when I go to the second part. I think it just... give him the candy and that's it. He gives me the light shard. Yeah, that's why I get the light shard. He gives it here. So, sorry, another spoiler. I'm a spoiler guy. Yeah. Anyway, one thing I did realize that I can break those. That's weird, you know? Another monster egg. Once again, not that much health, but definitely good in the long run. I also remember I do get the spike ball upgrade. So that's something neat. Okay, and I turn back to the monkey. The reason I turn to the monkey a lot is because the monkey's jumps are higher than Shantae's herself. Like, Shantae can jump and attack at the same time, but the monkey just has a very higher jump. So now I realize that I can go through here, but it takes a lot. Okay, so it is this part that I actually try up there. So I try the monkey, I realize the monkey doesn't work. Jumping around like an idiot, trying to figure out exactly what to do. And I try doing a monkey bullet. That doesn't work, because it doesn't go that far. I'm busy jumping around like an idiot, as always. As usual. Let's go for a minute. Gotta get something to drink here. Okay. Alright, so yeah, I'm jumping through here. And I'm trying to figure out exactly where to go. I stay stuck here for a bit to figure out exactly what to do. So I'm jumping around, and yeah, that's where I realized I can break those. So I'm just sitting here trying to figure out exactly what to do, and I try reaching over there, but I don't. Then I realize there's ledges over there, and I realize the spider can do so. But I turn to the mermaid again, like an idiot. But then I turn to the spider. I'm jumping around trying to see where she can stick, and that's one place. Stick again, another place. Now, this is where things get a little tricky, because as you can see, there is a ledge you can jump through, but it's very narrow and somewhere only the monkey can do so. Now, unfortunately, because I can't change in mid-air, at least transform in mid-air, I can change to Shantae, but I can't transform to another animal in mid-air. Yeah, I'm kind of stuck here. You know, I'm just wondering, like, what to do? What can I do? What can I do? And I guess somewhere along the way, I just kind of give up. But I'm thinking about it. I'm thinking either the heartbeat, that's the one I'm going to get, is probably the only power that can help me. And I think to myself, can I just try to time this with the spider? And I say, probably. I could time it with the spider. I'm switching between my weapons. I don't know why, but I realized that it's really useless. So I just kind of give up here. I'm jumping around, and I just kind of give up, and I do eventually quit and go back to the menu screen, but I don't know when. I think this is right here. Yeah, I think this is where I go back to the screen. I'm jumping around. You know, it's kind of hard to figure out what you're saying at one point when you have no audio to say it to. But anyway, I jump back down here and I realize, yeah, things are futile, so why should I just go back? I turn to the monkey again. I try jumping up, try to do everything again, and I say, no, screw it, I'm gonna give up. Yeah, this is where I give up and try to and just go back to the world select. To the world select we go! Hooray! Save guy! So now I'm gonna go to Desert Tower. I save the game, and I'm ready to go. So anyway, I teleport, use the teleportation device, to the next area. Hooray! So now, I'm here, and I ask the guy, hey, you know, can I get, hey, you know, I got some remains. You know, you delivered your remains for me. I say, yeah, I got it, but that's not enough. Now, I know he said some dragon heads, I do know that, but there was one thing I didn't note, and that was that, I don't know how much I had. I knew I had, like, around 3. And I say, okay, yeah, I've been through this way before. So I've been through that part. And I do remember that, you know, there was another part that I had a dragon head that I didn't do it yet, because it was on the other side, and I had to risk it. So yeah, that's the one. So I turn into the elephant once more and go, and there's the last one. And this is where I realized that I had 4 of the remains, and this is the 5th one. And then the stomp remains 5 out of 5, and they magically teleport me to the guy. You deliver, yes, the remains for me. Yeah, I got you the remains. Here you go, all 5 of them. Nice. Sniff, I chew, and I got sick. Yeah, I got sick. Check that by a doctor. So now he tells me there's a doctor here. And I say, okay, so there's a doctor. So now, at this point, I didn't know there was a doctor in Scuttletown. You know, I didn't check around. So anyway, I'm just jumping around collecting gems. Yeah, I guess that's the name of the currency. Then I just, so sick, someone got you sick. I checked that to see exactly what it was. Here comes dumbass over here. Whew. So I'm crawling through. Now I use the monkey. I should use the teleport to the next area. I don't really explore this area because I just want to get out of here and go to the next area. There's Shantae dancing, and I said I explored this place, so it's really, so I teleport again because because to my knowledge, I thought it was another place after this, and I realized there wasn't. So now I decided to just go back with the whistle and say, hey, Sky, come pick me up, you son of a whore. I don't say that, but might as well say it anyway. So I save the game and I go back to Scuttletown. Well, Skulltown Square, but yeah, I go back here. Whew. Oh man, how long are we at? 15 minutes into this. Okay, so I've been playing for 15 minutes by this point. So that's fine by me. So that's not a problem with magic, but no one can lose this much anyway. Okay, strange man. Alright. Alright, the mighty stomp. Okay. So I'm just looking to see find his doctor because I remember that the wizard told me that, well, not the wizard, the bandit told me that there was a doctor in here, so I'm asking around. That's usually the elephant dance. Yeah, I know. I'm looking everywhere. Wolf dance, so I looked everywhere here. I looked everywhere. And his kid told me to travel out there. He's at the house bath. So I was thinking, okay, thanks, kid. And that's where I see him. I usually don't come here for advice. Anyway, now he's checking on me completely out of leeches and asking me why I'm here today. This is very hot right now. By the way, that sounder really was someone at the door. Don't worry, it's already been gotten. It's already been taken care of. Okay. I don't know what he did to me. I don't know. Oh, well, he doesn't do anything. No, I did not see anything or feel anything. Definitely did not feel, definitely did not see. But anyway, I get a lollipop, so now I can go to the wizard. Alright, so at this point, I think I said I'll be right back after I find the wizard. So I guess at that point, I'll be right back after I find the wizard. Good for me. Alright, so I'm back here and I find the guy again. Wait a tick, I thought you didn't have any candy. Yeah, I have candy, but here's some candy. Thanks for the lollipop, I don't need it. I need to complete everything else. Candy out of nowhere. I kind of made an RKO reference here. And I'm a real wizard. No, I'm just half genie. But thank you for the compliment. And like I said, I get the light shard. Hooray for me! Light shardy for me. With an achievement unlocked. Yeah, we're good. You enjoy that. Anyway, yeah, like I said, I tried to see if I could break through here. I can't. I obviously need the heartbeat for that. So I go back to my inventory. Select the world. Once again, find the save guy, and we are out of here to the Skulltown Square. Whew. Man, drinks really get to you when you're trying to commentate, huh? I won't do that this time. I'm actually going to check everything. Alright, so let me do go for the light shard, and I found the light shard, and take the light shard, because I don't need it. It's attached by the dark shard, and the bushka. There you go. Here. Well, that's wonderful. So one piece left, uncle. Yep, we're almost at the end. Oh yeah, speaking of, she needs to split. So yeah, this is where Rytops goes, and this is where I have to go to my next objective. Whew. Oh man, it's so hot. Oh yeah, and I found the hypno bear's back. Isn't that fun? Yeah. Say what? The ammo baron. He is back. That is fun. Fun, fine, dandy for everything. I think I'm making some complaints about here. You know, it's not as much fun doing Kubo's commentary, and I still got more to go. But anyway, I get the Hypno Baron's castle up, and I get to go to the Hypno Baron. Honestly, his stage has some really interesting music. But it's only two objects that I have to get, which is unfortunate. So yeah, he says some distractions and attack Will. But yeah, anyway, I do know that once I got the heartbeat, I can fly anywhere I want to as long as I'm just mashing the button to fly. But anyway, I go here and I need a power up. So I need a few more power ups. So I'm wondering what to get. I was still gonna get all the silky and all the shampoos, or any of the other power ups. Also, I got this a super revive. Silky shampoo, so I get the silky shampoo and I try to get the super pipe ball afterwards. And I realize I get the Schmidt tar. So yeah, that's an interesting thing to note. The Schmidt tar. So I guess while I'm exploring places, I can actually get things. So, Sky, yeah, I'm very much being sarcastic with Sky here, saying, you know, yada yada yada, I'm being very sarcastic, yada yada. I don't know. I'm sorry, I'm speaking pretty damn low, but you know, that's how it happens. I'm more active when I'm actually playing the game, but not when I'm post-playing. I apologize for that. I really do. Anyway, now we go all the way up here to the Hypno Baron's castle, which only has two items, so not much to go on. That's sad. So anyway, to save the game, yes, we like to save the game. So there's Rhytops, and I say Rhytops, wait up. And we have this, you know, now she calls Sky no good bird brain. Make you walk all the way here, and I just noticed her belt buckle has a skull on it that kind of reminds me of a mixture between Skullgirls and the Zone animations. If you don't know what Zone animations are, look on Newgrounds and just have yourself a happy good time. So anyway, the creature of unspeakable horror, that's what she says. She heard her brothers talking about it, and Himalayan came to her for advice. A creature that open enough to rip open the fabric of space and time and wash away humankind in the seed of eternal woe. That was a mouthful to say, or something along those lines. Yes. So, yeah, technically they doomed humanity for a coffee. Yeah, they doomed humanity for a bag of coffee. I'm gonna lie, that is probably my favorite Shantae face. And it was before 9 a.m. You're right. It was before 9 a.m. You know, you gotta have your coffee before 9 a.m. God knows what will happen if you don't get your coffee before 9 a.m. Things happen. So anyway, so yeah, she'll watch the fireworks from here. Please do so. We don't need you screwing up anymore. So now it's time to explore the castle. You know, this is probably the time I probably should mention. I never mentioned this before, but there was supposed to be full voice acting. That was one of the goals for the Kickstarter. So anyway, well, before I get to that, anyway, before I get to back to the game, they did fund for, they wanted to get full voice acting for the entire game, but unfortunately, the funds didn't come in. So unfortunately for them, they only had enough to actually the last reach goal was to give everybody, which is Sky, Bolo, Rhytops, their own story. Everything else was not reached afterwards. That was it. There was nothing else reached. So it does make me wonder what would happen if they actually did get their own voices. Because you do hear Shantae voicing some lines fully. Not every line. Before she used to say certain words, but now she's voicing all lines. And here's Abner. And this is probably one of my favorite lines that she says. Coming up. Not this one. It's a brain on legs. You got something for me? Coffee? Brains? Coffee with brains in it? No, no one has those. No one has coffee with brains in it. I'd be concerned if they did. Then get lost. your butt. Your butt. Anybody who knows what they wanted to say, well, blame the people who wanted to keep it, you know, PG rated. But still, that face with the saying is probably my favorite. That's one of my favorite Shantae face. I said this before. Only because I feel like she can sound very sarcastic when she needs to. So anyway, like many of the places I decided to explore a bit, you know, I like exploring places to get out of here. Go away, please, thank you. Alright, so here I am exploring a new place. And there are some places I can't go just yet. Only because I don't have the heartbeat. You know, I correctly turned to the spire this time. Hooray for me. Okay, I can't go up there, sadly. So I'm searching for places to try to go, and I realize I can't do anything. So anyway, I climb up here, and I realize there's a door up here. So I can't go through that door unless I get the heartbeat. I kept calling it the Valkyrie every now and then, but I realized it's the heartbeat. So for those who were hearing me call it the Valkyrie, I do apologize and avenge. My words suck, and I am not good with them. Anyway, I turn back into the spider here. And I'm trying to jump time everything carefully so I can get past it again as usual. And I succeed. Really just have to jump that high, try again here, and nope, nothing. So I decide to just give up. Or do I? No, I give up, okay. So I give up here. And I'm jumping everywhere, trying to reach places, trying to see where I can go. I can't go anywhere, so I decided to just say screw it all and head on. Since there's nothing else up here for me to do. These guys are very easy to kill. Anyway, I could go more exploring if I wanted to, but I decided not to. I don't know which way I'd go. Oh yeah, I went this way. I don't know if I go back, that's the thing. I think I just continue on forward. And that's fine by me. I continue going forward. I see Abner there, and I see her. And then I wonder exactly, okay, there you go, the pipe ball. So anyway, now I got the pipe ball activated again, which is probably one of the more useful parts of this whole area, of this whole game. You know, having a super pipe ball. Eventually, I'll upgrade to the Schmittar. So anyway, I save, and I'm off to another part. And anybody knows those eyes, especially in Super Mario 64? Oh man, those eyes are definitely easy to spot, and definitely easy to activate. But, it's a good callback, and definitely classic. And, jump and boom! But there is one enemy in this stage that I hate. Okay, and nope. Boom! Hooray! And then she carries me over, and here comes Spider Lady. Oh god, Spider Lady. I have no idea how to deal with her. Sometimes I get lucky with hitting her, other times I don't. But sometimes I just say, you know what, I don't feel like dealing with it. Because she's going to continue blocking. Even when I try to get behind her, she continues to block. So, I try the elephant. And it's like, sometimes I win it, sometimes I get it, other times I don't. But eventually I decided to say, just screw it. I try the fireballs, nothing works. So I just say screw it and just go on. And from that point on, every time she appears, I try it again, nothing. And from that point, every time she appears, I decided to just avoid her. Because she's a pain in the ass. I get an orange for my efforts. And here comes these guys dropping lanterns. And these skeleton guys. Oh boy. I'm definitely gonna go exploring with this stuff tomorrow. Well, next time I play this. So I'm just trying to escape things now. Which is fine by me. Anyway, I don't trust myself. I turn into the monkey to jump high. Luckily, that works for my advantage. The thing about the monkey, the monkey jumps very high, but it's very hard to actually time some things. If only because his hitbox is hurt because the sprite is so small. I see more skeleton guys coming after me, but anyway, the spider monkey, the monkey's body is very small, so therefore it's kind of hard to actually time things. Here comes another one, I decide to avoid it, I get hit for my effort, but I move on. So anyway, I turn to the monkey this time just for a safe measure. I continue to jump, and I realize that there is a spider woman here, a snake woman. So I decided to buy something. I forgot what I bought the dryad dance here. Since that was the only dance I didn't buy, and I get to harvest fruit. I figured why not buy it, so I buy it, and that's all the dances. At least I assume that's all the dances. I do remember I actually died on one of these parts, but I see a flower. Remember the flower? Stomp. I get some gems for my efforts. Continue going. And this is where I die. Because I landed just a second too late and I stop and die. So anyway, I start back again with the monkey again. You know, jumping, jump. I see a snake woman, don't go to her again because I already got what I needed. Continue onward, duck for no reason. And I continue onward. And more onward. And jump onward. At the last minute. And then more of these moving platforms. Another obstacle in my way. Forget that. See that guy. Get hit. I'm trying not to get hit a lot. Because another snake woman. I decided to turn to a monkey to jump extra high. You can't hit me. And that's when I finally get to the boss. As you can tell from the title, the boss is both the Hypno Baron and the Squid Baron. Hypno Baron. I remember I gave him one of the most interesting voices. Let me see if I can do it again. Frog, it's you! No matter! My incantation is already complete! The gasp. Tremble of fear as you witness the end of your world!
No!
Yes.
Behold! The creature of unspeakable horror!
And I get a very neat laugh from here. I wish you guys can hear it. And then I realize that Roundhead has to be only the Squid Baron. With a stupid little cute face. And a yo. Huh? Yeah, my thoughts exactly, Shantae. Huh?
Squid Baron?
Yep. And I still love that face. Check it, I already reached fistball status. And I kind of go on a bit of a rant about this. So I'm going on a bit of a rant here. Blah, 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 whatever. Then once I finish my rant, I just continue with the game. I don't really like talking for this guy. I'm more for the Hypno Baron because I like his voice better. It's the ones that would have been top billing. It is. I'll be surprised if they didn't name a game after me. Shantae vs. the Point Squid Baron, they call it. Funny enough, that was actually the name of the achievement once you beat it. No, Squid Baron's Quest, Star Shantae. If I just make a Squid Baron game, I guess you get a cheap DLC if you act nicely. I think a complaint here. No, color palette swap. 99 cents sounds about right. Then I kind of... And I say, you're out of your mind, Squid Baron. And I started listening off some of the things here. And then that's when she starts. First of all, the titles always have a colon or and the in the name. I say, yeah, it's true. So that was true, but except for the first game. Second, the Squid Baron spin-off game will only appeal to a subset of the same audience, so it's going to sell like buns. I really didn't know the comparison.
How embarrassing!
And third, swap my color palette for yours will make you red and purple, which you already are. Well, then again, now he'll be a darker shade of purple. And I just go,
I'm there, you. Let's do this all crazy style.
Now cue the funky boss track and come at me. Which is a stupid one. So I decided to say, you know what? Screw you. Get the pipe ball and just start smashing away his butt cheeks. And I actually got bored. I actually said to myself, you know what? I'm bored here. Because I'm literally bored. You're boring me, Squid Bearing. Like, it wasn't really that. It was, like, Squid Bearing's not that hard. Especially when you have the Pike Ball and stuff. Not to mention a whole bunch of healing items. It just makes, well, him a cakewalk. Matter of fact, most of these bosses tend to be a cakewalk once you actually get a whole bunch of healing items. Then it's really just saying, ha 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 ha. So then, now I have to fight both barons. Which I say, yes, this is actually better. So now I go back to the Super Pike Ball strategy. Because as you can see, I'm pretty reckless with this. So I decided to fight off Squid Baron first, because the Emerald Baron by himself isn't really that much of a danger. It's mostly the Squid Baron. So anyway, I decided to go with the Monster Egg, and this is where I realized that the Monster Egg, as much as I get it most of the time, doesn't really amount to much help. Which I guess it shouldn't be, considering that it's common, but then the orange is less common. So that kind of tells you a bit of something, don't you think? You know, I'm just smacking them around, getting the Squid Baron, getting the Hippo Baron whenever I can, smacking them both. And I say, okay, so now time to get the Rose. So Rose is very good. Heals me for all my health. Or a lot of my health. So I'm still trying to get the Squid Baron, trying to eliminate him. I think I do it somewhere in the middle. Right there. I eliminate him, and now I have the Hypno Baron left. So I say, okay, Hypno Baron, I can be just as reckless. Only he takes a little bit more health from me. You know, Squid Baron only took one, but Hypno Baron takes two. So I know that I only take a few hits before I can actually start healing. Let's take one more hit, go back to the menu, heal, and continue on with my reckless pursuit. And that was the last one I needed. And now I've won. So hurrah, hurrah, hurrah for me. Yay for me, my name is XaneKudo. I win. And we blew up Squid Baron for good. Good. That is very good. I hope you're happy now, Hypno Baron. He might have been a big jerk face, but deep down he just wanted to be loved.
Oh, he will be. He will be. You see, I summoned him to the option his merchandising rights.
Oh, say what?
Squid Baron hats and mugs and t-shirts, crew necks, and raglans.
But whatever happened to ripping open the fabric of space and time and washing away humankind in a sea of eternal woe?
Who told you that? I don't say that. No, he's greasing the fabric of leisure time and blowing away humankind in a sea of heavily weaved 100% cotton comfort. Who told you that? Squid Baron merch will fund evil for all of eternity. And I'm out.
I'm going home to take a very long, very hot bath. And I said to here, I might as well just kill Roddy while I'm at it, only to realize that, oh yeah, I can't kill Roddy. She's already dead at this point. And I'm kind of sad. And you see the achievement, Shantae versus the important Squid Baron. So I'm lamenting on the fact that I can't kill Roddy. I say, sadness, I can't kill Roddy, I wish I could. So now it says, don't tell the genie, blah 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 blah, and get your harpy so we can get this over with. So now I figure, okay, what's the next transformation? And then I realize it's the harpy. Definitely the most useful out of all of them. Definitely. There are just some places that the harpy can do. So I realize the harpy just acts just the same as it did in the first game, where you gotta tap the button repeatedly to keep flying into the air. So, with that said, that's the harpy. Hooray! So, now back here, congratulations. You throw a football 5 times in a single day. Good for me. That's good. That's gotta be a new personal best. Well, one of those thanks to you, dumbass. I want to kill her, but I can't. She's already dead. I won't stop him from trying. Well, being a genie is only half hero sure isn't easy. I know what you mean, Banana, thanks. But I realize that Uncle to get that final come upon it. So what is it anyway, Uncles? According to this, the building mechanism shows the handcrank mechanism. That's all good. But here's where he gets to shine, and I say, sugar nuts. Well, that's right, we're going to improvise. Okay, so here, I'm just going to save you all the trouble. Basically, what they want is a hamster, because they're going to use a hamster wheel. But now we're going to have to get a dead hamster. Well, zombie hamster, actually. And that's brilliant. Yes, brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. So now we need iron and a zombie hamster. So we're seriously going with this plan? Yeah, we're going with this plan. We're going with the plan to summon... Oh no, the cops are coming after me. That's not fun. Oh, the sounds, if you can hear it. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Oh. They came for me, they saw, and they tried to kill me. So anyway, Poe has the zombie hamster. That's good thing. That's good news. Good news, everyone. We have a zombie hamster. Ugh. And now to get my second drink of the day. It's almost over, so don't worry. It's just very hot right now. And the iron slab, we just gotta ask them around town. So, I forgot what happens here. But I don't have any gems to actually get anything else, so I decided to just go around and ask around town. Oh yeah, pink blob woman. So I recognize the kid has something, but I don't ask him yet. So I decided to go find the blob woman, who happens to be... Hey, Grandma! And calls me Honeymelon.
That's good. That's good.
So anyway, she needs a new hat. On an unrelated note, cotton candy soda tastes really good. It's an acquired taste. You guys should try it. So anyway, I'm trying to find out, and this guy sees the Azure Knight, and I remember that I had a Vorpal Blade from the dude who says Monkey Butt. And I gave him the most interesting voice. I am the Azure Knight! You were sent forth by the Crimson Knight to retrieve his real headwear! I was not yielded to a knave such yon, however stands. I will be inclined to bequeath it to you, shall thine parvionis me with a fine football blade, dust in the tears of a saddened newborn orangutan. How's my procure said blade by descending into the ocean depths, and to the putrid sores, and to the place where the adventure man would challenge you, if not all successful in surmounting his cerebral tournament of trickery and deception? And deliver unto me the vocal blade before the setting sun touches the vast ocean. The regal headwear shall be thine. I see thou hast procured the vocal blade.
Yo, yeah, I did.
Hey, buddy.
You are both noble and brave and quite beautiful. Be my wife. No. Very well then. You're also beautiful.
So yeah, that's what I said. I forgot what I said here.
And so I'll be still on to thine down head, thy regal headwear, as promised.
And I get a foxy grandma hat. Lucky me!
Where is it upon thy head?
Yeah. It is a phony baloney accent. Well, I don't know about baloney, but it is a phony accent. A weird one, and a funny one at best. So anyway, I finally do get the Vorpal Blade. And I'm trying to lament on why is it called Foxy Grandma. Oh dear. Yes, it really is, and I'm just as shocked as you are. So anyway, I forgot what she gives me. Yeah, I give it to her. Okay, she wears it. Foxy Grandma. You are a grandma, but I don't know about Foxy. I don't know who would... I look hotter than a Friskast 2 worm. I don't want to know what a hot Friskast 2 worm looks like. And springtime. No, I don't want to know what springtime. Oh, oh god. A rain is all coming on. And
This gets disgusting. I don't think we want to watch TV for grandma. I think we're fine. And here it goes. And she literally hurls my weapon at me. Ew. I got grandma barf. Well, I don't want to keep it. I really don't. But anyway, I think this is where I save and this is where I end things. So, I'm trying to look around to see exactly what else to do here. I need heal, I believe. I actually want to talk to her to see what she has to say. A hint? Yes, a hint. You look for the zombie brother. Visit her tribe in the cabin. Use the power of flight. Okay, so that's where I have to go next. The zombie. Let's go back to Hypno Baron. But before I go back there, I'm going to actually explore everything else with the Harpy to see if I can pick up everything else. Because I do want to get this game a complete run through. Unlike the last times. So anyway, I'm done here. That was the entire Let's Play. So, I'm talking. But yeah, that was the Let's Play, and this is my post-commentary to said Let's Play. There's been some distractions, but hopefully you guys got everything. You know, I don't plan to do this that much. I just wanted to do it because, again, the audio sucked. And because the audio sucked, I had to do this. But, thank you guys so much for watching my entire progress through this. Next time, we will have better audio, and I will have a working microphone, cameras, whatever. But until that time, thank you guys so much for watching, and thank you guys for listening to my post commentary. And if you like the video, share it with your friends. And until next video, see you guys next time. So have fun with the dancing. Good for you guys.